One of the features of Julia that sets it apart from other languages is something called multiple dispatch. Let's take a look at an example. I'm in VS Code and I've already created a new .jl file. I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. Let's start by declaring and defining a function named myTypeOf. This function takes a single argument of type int64 and returns the string int64. The keyword return is used when you want to be specific about what the function should return. In many cases, using the keyword return is not required, but I'm using it in this example to make it clear to the reader that this function is returning this string. Note that this is a generic function with one method. I'll explain what that means in a few minutes. Because I declared a data type for the argument in this function definition, this function will only work if the argument used is of type int64. In Julia, you have the option of reusing the function name, but using a different data type for the argument. This gives you the ability to change the function's behavior based on the data type of the argument. Note that this is now a generic function with two methods. In Julia, every function is referred to as a generic function. According to the Julia documentation, a generic function is conceptually a single function, but consists of many definitions or methods. In object-oriented languages like JavaScript and Python, the term method means a function tied to some object. In Julia, the term method means something very different. This is also from the Julia documentation. A definition of one possible behavior for a function is called a method. So in this example, the function myTypeOf has two methods, which means that there are two possible behaviors for this function. Julia will determine which method to use based on the data type of the argument. Let's add one more method to the myTypeOf function, which will serve as a catch-all for all other data types. Okay, so now the myTypeOf function has three methods. So three possible behaviors for this function, depending on the data type of the argument. In other programming languages, reusing a function name while using different data types for the arguments in the function definition is called function overloading. But the term function overloading is often confused with the term multiple dispatch. But they're not the same thing. Let's take a look at an example of multiple dispatch. In this function declaration and definition, a data type was not declared for the function argument, In many other programming languages, this would not be allowed. In many other programming languages, you need to specify the data type for all function arguments. Otherwise, you'll get an error message. But in Julia, you can declare and define truly generic functions that can be used with any data type, thanks to multiple dispatch. In Julia, the term multiple dispatch means that Julia will dispatch the most appropriate method based on the data types of all of the function arguments at the time the function is called. Julia will then compile that one method and evaluate it. Julia will ignore all of the other methods. In this example, my generic function will determine which method to call for the myType of function based on the data type of the argument in my generic function. Let's try calling my generic function using several different data types. In the REPL, you'll see the output 1 is type int 64. Now let's try using an irrational number. In the REPL, you'll see the output pi is type number. The myType of function doesn't have a method for an irrational number, so Julia picks the closest method, which is the method using the number data type. Let's try one more example using an array. This time in the REPL, you'll see the output array 123 is type not defined yet. The myType of function doesn't have a method for an array. Also, an array is not a number, so Julia picks the closest method, which is the method using the any data type. So you get three different behaviors when using three different data types for the function argument, while using a generic function that never declared a data type in the function definition. If you're new to programming, this may seem logical and not that impressive. But trying to create truly generic functions is very difficult to do in other programming languages. In Julia, it's relatively easy to create generic functions, thanks to multiple dispatch. The other thing that multiple dispatch allows you to do is to create a custom data type, add a new method using that custom data type, and then reuse the generic function without making any modifications to that code. Let's take a look at an example. So in this example, you're creating a new struct with one field. Using this custom data type, you can add a new method to the function myTypeOf. So the function myTypeOf now has four methods. This creates a new instance of your custom data type. And now you can reuse the generic function using this instance. In the REPL, you'll see the output dog ecdog is type dog. Note that we did not have to modify the function definition of myGenericFunction, nor did we have to reevaluate it before calling it again. Thanks to multiple dispatch, Julia was able to figure out which method of the myTypeOfFunction to call based on the data type of the argument in myGenericFunction. So why is this important? This goes back to the concepts of abstraction and decomposition. Multiple dispatch is a higher level of abstraction compared to function overloading. Multiple dispatch gives you the ability to create truly abstract generic functions. At the same time, multiple dispatch gives you the ability to break down your projects into smaller pieces of reusable code. In this example, imagine that one person in one part of the world is a developer who is maintaining a list of the different methods for the myTypeOfFunction. And imagine that another person in another part of the world is a developer who is maintaining the myGenericFunction definition. And imagine that a third person in a third part of the world is a user and not a developer who wants to use myGenericFunction, but wants to use it with their own custom data type that no one else will ever use. Thanks to multiple dispatch, this third person can define a new method for the myTypeOfFunction just for their own custom data type. And then this third person can call myGenericFunction without making any modifications to it. And the code will just work. This imaginary scenario is a high-level oversimplification for how the Julia ecosystem works, and is made possible in large part thanks to multiple dispatch. Before I go, I want to show you the methods function. The methods function will display a list of the different methods available for any function. So the myTypeOfFunction currently has four different methods, or four possible behaviors for this function, depending on the data type of the argument. While the myGenericFunction function currently has one method, so it has the same behavior regardless of the data type of the argument. In Julia, the arithmetic operators are also functions. So the addition operator, or the plus sign, is a function. In Julia version 1.9.3, the addition operator has 207 different methods. If you maximize the REBL window, you can scroll through and see all of the different methods available for the addition operator. These are different methods for different combinations of different data types for the operands. Because someone has already done this work, this is why you were able to create the myAdd function in the last chapter without having to declare any data types in the function definition. The myAdd function from the last chapter is an example of a generic function with one method that can take arguments of any data type. Based on the data types of the arguments, Julia will use multiple dispatch to figure out which of the 207 methods to call for the addition operator. One of the technical differences between multiple dispatch and function overloading in other languages is that in function overloading, you need to pre-compile all of the different behaviors in advance, whether you use them or not. In Julia, Julia does not pre-compile all of the different methods in advance. Julia will only compile the one method that it needs at the time that the function is called. so that may have been a little too much for a beginner's course. But that's the basics of using multiple dispatch in Julia. In the next chapter, you'll learn what an anonymous function is, and how to use it in Julia.